Over the years, scientific advances have been made in the diagnosis of herpes simplex viral infections. However, even today, testing is still not perfect, it's still not 100% accurate, and causes much confusion. In this video, we'll take a look at herpes simplex viral testing for genital herpes and what the different test results mean. Genital herpes is a common sexually transmitted disease around the world. It is caused by infections with the herpes simplex viruses types 1 and 2. Herpes simplex virus type 1 usually causes infections on the face, around the mouth, or around the nose. But recently, in economically advanced nations, the incidence of herpes simplex type 1 anogenital infections has been on the rise. Herpes simplex type 2 infections are almost exclusively found in the anogenital area. Herpes screening is not routinely performed at patient visits. Rather, it is only recommended for specific situations, such as when patients have partners, sexual partners, who test positive for herpes virus, or patients who are recently exposed, or patients who have atypical lesions, or patients who are diagnosed clinically and need a serologic confirmation, or if they come from high-risk groups. For people with active lesions, direct testing for the virus is the preferred method of diagnosis. This could either be done by viral culture or by the use of PCR, a test that amplifies the genetic material of the virus. The sensitivity of culture is rather low, that is, its ability to identify people who are actually infected by the virus is just about 50 to 75%, depending on the stage of development of the outbreak. Its specificity, however, is 100%. PCR has a higher sensitivity of 98%, and its specificity, that is, its ability to identify people who do not have the infection, is 99%. Either of these tests can give a definitive diagnosis for herpes simplex infection and can differentiate and identify the type of virus that is causing the infection. These tests are most sensitive within 3 to 4 days of the onset of an outbreak. Serologic testing involves the measurement of antibodies produced against a specific protein found on the surface of the viruses that differentiates the two viruses. Serologic tests give their result in an index value that measures the level of antibodies that are found in the serum tested. Although the newer types of serologic testing have higher rates of accuracy than the older ones, the possibility of having false positive and false negative tests is still an ongoing problem. This is especially an acute problem in the borderline range of index values known as the equivocal zone or the low positive zone. A test result would be equivocal if the test is unable to determine whether or not antibodies against the virus are present in the serum tested. A test would be false positive if there is user error or if there is improper handling or storage of the specimen. False negative tests would occur in situations in which people who are recently exposed are tested before the body has a chance to produce antibodies. Such tests need to be repeated within 3 months, which is the average time the body needs to produce antibodies against the virus. The most popular serologic test in use currently is the Herpes Elect, which is an enzyme immune assay that carries an equivocal range of greater than 0.9 to less than 1.1. Tests that fall within this range should be repeated within a month. And if that repeat test is also equivocal, then a confirmatory test should be performed with a Western blot. Any test result that falls within the range of 1.1 to 3 is considered low positive. In patients without risk factors, without active lesions, or who are not in a high-risk group, these test results need to be confirmed. A confirmatory test, such as the Western blot, should be performed. Western blot is also an antibody-based test, but its sensitivity and specificity is 99%, and it is considered the gold standard. If both the confirmatory test and the antibody test are positive, then a diagnosis of herpes simplex virus infection can be made with certainty. In low-risk populations, a low positive test result may very well be a false positive. Thank you for watching. I hope this video clarifies some of the questions you had on herpes viral testing. If you did, like and share the video with friends and family. Leave your comments in the box below and support the channel by subscribing. Once again, thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.